Hey guys, this is Don Scott Schnoor here from One Automation Whiz, and we just launched the brand new One Automation Whiz website. And I know a lot of our merchants either moved to a new platform or a new site design, and setting up all of the redirects so that your old pages point to your new pages can be daunting. For example, if you had a static HTML site, you might have a URL that looks like www.yourdomain.com/page1.htm. And then maybe later you redesign the site using WordPress, and now the site would be www.yourdomain.com/page1/. Well, if you've been directing and building links to your old website pages with a .htm or .php or .html extension, you really need to go into your server and redirect those pages so that they point, the old pages point to the new pages. That way you keep all the good search engine link power that you've developed. It also makes it easy for Google to respider your site and helps you keep your rankings. Now, this is why I'm doing this video. Once we submitted our new sitemap and did all of our redirects, Google still had a difficult time finding some of our pages. So in our Google Webmasters Tool account, and if you don't have a Webmasters Tool account, you really should get one, because it will make getting rankings in Google so much easier, because they will show you exactly what you need to fix in your website. Now, Google is going to, under the Diagnostics tab, Google, you want to click on the crawl rate and then click on sitemap. Now, we have a sitemap for our website, and it lists all of the pages in the new design. However, some of these pages are coming back as 404 errors, meaning that they can't be found. And Google's is so nice that it spiders the entire site, and then it tells you specifically which pages are linking to a bad 404 page. So the first thing you want to do is confirm that in fact you have a page that is showing up. So you can just go to that link and click the link, and there it is. That page does show up. So we know that page is live. So what Google's going to let us do is you take the URL of that page that you want to let Google know about or help them out here, and you go to your new settings called Fetch as Googlebot. Click on this link and then type in the URL of the 404 page that Google can't find that you do know is there. Click Fetch. Google will go through and try to find it, and look, it says, okay, we did find it. We were successful. Now, what you can do here is you can either just do nothing. You've basically told Google it's there and they found it, and they'll come back. Or if you're a little a little impatient, you can click the Submit to Index button, and this will actually tell Google to come and fetch and index this page. Not just look at it, but come and get it. And it's not going to guarantee that the page is going to be indexed, but if it's a major part of your site, a major category page or a major product page, they absolutely will. Now, you can submit via URL or the URL and then all the linked pages that are linked from the page that you just submitted. My suggestion is that you just submit the individual URL, let Google spider the rest of the pages, and that's all you have to do. Now, if you have any other pages that you need to do this for, go back to your crawl errors, look in your sitemap, and you will see that you can just pull a new page. This is the one I want right here, and I'll go back to Fetch as Googlebot. Paste that in. Little difficulty there. Fetches Googlebot. Paste that in. Make sure the... All right. Now, Google, go fetch it and confirm that it's there. See, they just fetched it, and they were successful. If you click on that link, what that's going to show you is it actually is going to confirm and show you the actual text on that page, so that we know that Google found this. Now, I can submit that to the index, or I can let Google come back and find it on its own. Google gives you 50 fetches per month, And it's not something that you should really do all the time. You should really only use the Fetches Googlebot tool to make sure that you're getting website pages that that you know are there that Google has a hard time finding, or for whatever reason did a 404 error on. And you know, the Googlebot spider is not perfect, so sometimes you have to help it. Again, whether or not you submit these to the index after Google finds them is entirely up to you. If Google fetched it, they've now put it in the index for spidering, and they will come and spider it. If you're kind of impatient, like I said, you could just click submit to index, and that'll give Google a command, yes, please index this page. So there you have it. If you have any other questions, just leave a comment, and I'll try to answer them as quick as I can. This is Don Schnort from OneAutomationWiz.com.